Very good morning to all my dear students. I welcome you all. Dear student, we are on to the quality management system. So the introductory details related with the quality management system that already we saw in our previous lecture. Now today our topic of discussion that is associated with the concept of quality. But before directly going to the concept of quality, let's finish some of the principles that are required in case of the quality management system. So these principles are called as quality management principles. So in order to get the quality, what the principles are there, what are all those, and what is the necessity in order to have the quality. So these principles that are mentioned into the ISO 9000 and the fundamental beliefs that form the foundation of the ISO requirement. So the fundamental belief of certain basic principles that will leads to the quality excellence by following them. So these principles, they need to be followed in order to achieve the quality. And these are based on the practical applications. These has to be practically applied. And these can be applied at any level of the quality pyramid. If you see the quality pyramid, there is a quality control at its top. In order to achieve this quality, there is a quality management team, and the quality management team that has to ensure the total quality management. So this is the triad, this is the pyramid. Now, if you see the principles, there are some A1 to 8 principles. Now these principles can be enlisted as customer focus, leadership, involvement of people, process approach, system approach to management, continual improvement, factual approach to decision making, and mutually beneficial supplier relationship. So the quality or the ISO 9000 that is based on all these 8 principles. Now let us see in detail that what are all individual principles. The first is the customer focus. Our prime focus that should be onto the customer, and the quality control is required in order to understand and meet the basic requirement. Little or no knowledge of the customer perception that will leads to losing the quality. So quality management, these are responsible for better understanding of overall requirements and the customer satisfaction that is to be tracked. The total quality management, they are involved in customer information that is collected systematically throughout the company, and the knowledge of the customer perception and ability to offer the preferred product. So all that is the QC, QVM and TQVM, their focus that should be prime onto the customer. Leadership, if you see the leadership, so that is different from QC to QVM to TQVM. QC, they has the management provide resources sufficient for the quality control. Now the QM, that is the management establishes the policy, that is the leadership policy, their objective and the environment to control process that ensures the quality. The TQM, that will consist of the different managers which will provide personal examples that create customer satisfaction, and the quality is a strategic issue. The third principle, that is the involvement of the people. The QC, they are involved in people and they must create and operate the basic processes. they does not draw on the full talents. QVM, that is the processes defined and the personas, these are qualified. They will recruit the employees, they will contribute to the improvement. The TQVM, employees fully engaged and entirely involved. The high level of communication between leaders and the employees, that is necessary. The process approach, in order to get the quality, the QC that is involved in the inspection and testing, which is very, very common, and the controlled processes, they will provide the feedback. The QVM, that is the movement from control of only process output to control the process itself. The additional processes such as management reviews and the corrective actions, these are necessary in order to improve the processes. Whereas the TQM, that will optimize the resources and they are responsible for continual improvement and they will use the process measures. The fifth principle, that is the system approach to the management. The inspection and control system that will work together but not integrated with the rest of the organization as far as QC is concerned. The quality management that is moved to integrate the process for creating the product with verification of the final product, focus onto the customer satisfaction. And the TQVM, they will fully understand the interaction among the processes and continually they will improve it. The sixth principle, that is the continual improvement. QC will focus on improvements to ensure that the customer does not receive the defective product. QVM, they will focus on improving the effectiveness and efficiency of the quality management system, mature the corrective and the preventive loop, whereas total quality management, they will focus on efficiently meeting customer needs through the quality management system. Leaders are involved in improvement of the processes. The seventh principle, that is factual approach to decision making. The QC uses data in order to distinguish non-conformities, the statistical data that will ensure the requirement that are met, and little use of data in order to measure the trends. Quality management, that is the facts and data used to make decisions regarding quality management system, which will focus onto the improvement of the process. The total quality management, they will analyze, use to improve market position and information gathered from all members of the organization. The eighth and the last principle, that is the mutually beneficial supplier relationship. For QC, some validation of the supplier product that is necessary. The QVM, that they will processes to define the document, they will review and evaluate the well-developed and defined validation processes. Whereas the total quality management, they will focus changes with established strategic alliances or partnerships, the mutual commitment to customer satisfaction, focus on continual improvement, and becomes the common. Now, as far as the concept of quality is concerned, we have to understand what is the quality. Now, if we will see the just dictionary meaning, it means the essential characteristic or the superior characteristics. Some other definitions that are accepted in various organization, or say from organization to organization, their quality means it is different. If it is in case of educational institution, the knowledge the student they will gain, that is the quality. If it is the transport to provide service to that of the passenger, that is the quality. If it is the manufacturing unit, the ultimate product and its quality, that means its durability, its workability, its persistence. So that is in terms of their quality. So from organization to organization, the meaning or the concept of quality that will goes on differing. So the ultimate is what? It is the customer satisfaction. and the quality is fitness for its use. If it is the product, it should be fitness for its use. If it is the service, then it is the customer satisfaction. What is the TQM? A comprehensive organization-wide effort to improve the quality of products and services applicable to all organization. That is what is said to be the total quality management. What it is? It is the organization effort. It is the comprehensive organization-wide effort in order to improve the quality of the products and services that is applicable to all organizations. Now, the ultimate beneficiary is the customer. Now, who is the customer? What is the meaning of customer? Anyone who is impacted by the product or process delivered by an organization, that is to be called as a customer. For educational institute, the student, these are the customer. For the manufacturer, the ultimate users, these are the customers. There are external customers, there are internal customer. External customer, these are the end user as well as intermediate processors. Other external customers may not be purchasers, but may have some connection with the product. Let's say, for example, there is a dealer, distributor, sub-distributors, retailers, right? So all these dealers, sub-distributors, distributors, retailers, all these are the external customers. They will not directly use the product, but these are involved in the process of handling of the product. Whereas the ultimate purchaser, these are the ultimate customers. Internal customer, other divisions of the company that will receive the processed product. Now, what is the product? The output of the process carried out by the organization. It may be good. It may be goods. For example, automobiles, missiles, it may be software. Let's say, for example, a computer code or a report or a service, like say banking service or say the insurance service or say the transport service. How is customer satisfaction is achieved? The two different dimensions are there, the product features and the freedom from the deficiencies. The product feature that will refers to that of the quality of design. In order to bring any product into the market, the product should have its quality, its design. And what is the design of that quality that refers to that of the product features? Let's say, for example, in manufacturing industry, the performance, reliability, durability, ease of use, and aesthetic, all these are the product features. Let's say, for example, there is a pen. How the pen that will performs? What kind of ink is there? Whether the ink that will spoil the paper, if it is there, then the performance may not be good. Reliability, how much, for how long duration the pen that will remains, isn't it? There are some pens which are not reliable, like say some local brands. Compared to that, if we compare the Reynolds, that is the reliable brand, which will be having the durability. Ease of use. Let's say, for example, the cello pen will be having the rubber grip. So that rubber grip that will makes it easy to use, right? Compared to that of the Reynolds. Reynolds doesn't have it. Aesthetic. If you see the aesthetic, again, the look wise, the Reynolds pen that will looks very good. And once upon a time, it was the market leader as far as the pen products are concerned. But now, again, some few other pen manufacturers, they have taken the place because of improvement of the product features. Example in service industry, that is the accuracy, timeliness, friendliness, and courtesy, knowledge of the servers. How the transporter, they are providing service, how timely the travel that will reaches, right? Whether it will follow the timeline or not, whether the staff that is friendly or not, whether they are assisting to that of the customers in carrying or in taking or in loading their luggages or not. So all that will forms the part of the courtesy in case of the service industry. Freedom from the deficiencies. It refers to that of the quality of conformance, right? The higher conformance means fewer complaints and increased customer satisfaction. This is related to a free from defect, right? higher conformance of the quality. That means the product is very, very good. They don't have any kind of complaint and there is no market feedback, or there is no negative market feedback as far as the product is concerned. Now, why quality is required? The reasons for getting quality, that will become a cardinal priority for most of the organizations. There are several reasons, like say the competition, changing customer, changing product mix, product complexity, and the higher levels of the customer satisfaction. Competition, that today's market demands the high quality product at the low cost, right? If you see the just mobiles, isn't it? Today there is a market leader which is said to be the Xiaomi, right? So the Xiaomi that will provide the good quality along with that of the at an affordable price. If we just compare the Xiaomi with that of the another brands like say the Samsung, which is somewhat costlier one, and if we just compare it with that of the Apple or the iPhone, that is the luxurious brand, right? So which will be having the high degree of quality, but they don't have the affordability. So that is the problem. So today's market that will demand the high quality at a low cost. Having high quality reputation is not enough. Internal cost of maintaining the reputation, that should be less. So because of the online shoppings and all, they could not be able to have the intermediary. That way, that's why they are in a position to provide the product Xiaomi brands at an affordable price with the same configuration, with the same features. Changing the customer. The new customer is not only commanding the priority based on the volume, but is more demanding about the quality system. So again, the changing customer, that is the reason that why the quality is required. Changing product mix, the shift from low volume, high price to high volume, low price have resulted in a need to reduce the internal cost of poor quality. Product complexities. As system have become more complex, the reliability requirement for the suppliers of components have become the most stringent. That's why the quality is required. Higher levels of the customer satisfaction. The higher customers' expectations are getting spanned by the increasing competition. Therefore, relatively simpler approaches in order to quality the product, like say inspection for quality control, and incorporation of the internal cost of poor quality into the selling price, that might not work for today's complex market environment. As far as the quality perspectives are concerned, everyone that will define the quality based on their own perspective of it. Now, typical response about the definition of the quality that would include the perfection, right? The finishing. For one person, that might be the perfection, might be the quality. The consistency, how consistently the product is going to be performing. Hassle-free use is there. So that is the quality for the purpose. Eliminating waste, right? The durability. Speed of delivery. The speed of use, if it is the mobile phone. Or how speedily there is a delivery. If you are ordering something on in online mode, if they are taking just 2 or 3 days in order to deliver the product, and if another is taking say 7 to 8 days, then definitely the one which will going to deliver within 2 or 3 days, that might be the quality for few of the people. Complies with the policies and the procedures. What the claims they are making, what the guarantees, what the warranties they are giving, right? So conformance or the compliance to that one, that may be the quality. Doing it right the first time, right? So giving the good product, or first impression is always the last impression. Most of the product manufacturer, they will believe in that. So for them, that is the quality. Delighting or the pleasing to the customer, the one who will provide the good service, the one who will have the good kind of, say, the customer representatives who are going to be attending. So for them, how they are going to be welcoming, how they are talking, how they are communicating. So that might be the service, or that might be the quality, the total customer satisfaction and the service. So all these are the different perspectives, the quality it means. If you see the levels of the quality, there are different levels, like say organization level, at process level, and these organizational level, at organization level, we need to ask the following questions in order to achieve the quality. Which product or services meet your expectations? Which product and services you need that you are not currently receiving? At process level, if you see, we need to ask the following questions, like say, what products and services are most important to the external customers? What processes produce those products and the services? What are the key input to those processes? Which processes have most significant effect on the organization's performance and its standards? Now, these are some of the additional views of the quality in services, some technical quality versus the functional quality, expectations and the perceptions. Now, technical quality, that is the core element of the good or service, and the functional quality, that is the customer perception, that how the good functions or the services that are going to be delivered. So there is a need to concentrate on to both technical as well as the functional quality. There is a satisfaction and there is a expectation, the customer's prior expectation, that is generalized and the specific service experience, and their perception of service performance, which will affect their satisfaction with a service. Now, if you'll see the satisfaction, it is equal to that of the perception of performance minus the expectation. So what is the performance? And in that performance, or the performance that is related with the product and expectation that is from the customer side. So how the product that will meets to that of the expectation of the customer, and the difference of this, that is nothing but the satisfaction. Now, there are different philosophies that is associated as far as the qualities are concerned, and these philosophies has been given by the different peoples, and these peoples are called as, these are known as the quality gurus. Now, what these quality gurus are? These are the individuals who have been identified as making a significant contribution in order to improving the quality of the goods and the services. So there is a list of people like say the Walter H. Schwart, W. Edward Deming, Joseph M. Juran, Armand Fregbaum, Philip Crosby, Genichi Taguchi, and Kaoru Ishikawa. So all these are the people, these are popularly known as the quality gurus. Now, there are the three of the quality gurus who had compared as per as the definition of quality is concerned. Now, if we will compare the Crosby, Deming and the Juran, as per as the definition of quality is concerned, according to the Crosby, the conformance to the specification, that is their definition. If we will see the Deming, a predictable degree of uniformity and dependability at low cost and suitable to the market. So to provide the product at low cost, that is the quality according to the Deming. And as far as Juran is concerned, so it is the fitness of use, how the product that is suitable for its use, how it is easy to use. So that is the quality. The degree of senior management responsibility. Now, the Crosby says that the senior manager, these are responsible for the quality. Deming say that they are responsible for 85% of the quality problems. And Juran will says that less than 20% of the quality problem, these are due to the workers. So that means 80% that is on behalf of the manager side. As far as the performance standard and the motivation is concerned, Crosby says that there should be a zero defect into that of the product as far as the quality is concerned. According to Deming, the quality has many scales. They uses the statistics in order to measure the performance in all areas, and the critical of the zero defect. There should not be any kind of defect. The Juran says that there is a avoidance of the complaints to the product or the to perfect work. The general approach, according to the Crosby, the prevention and non-inspection. So that is the general approach. The Deming will says that reduce the variability by continuous improvement. Cases That is the mask inspection. CZ is the mask inspection. So we have to continuously go on increasing the quality. If we are going to be increasing the quality, there is no need to go for going to be inspecting, because the quality has been achieved. The Juran will says that the general management approach to the quality, especially to the human elements. As far as the structure of the Crossbeck quality is concerned, they had given the 14 different steps in order to improve the quality. The Deming, they had given the 14 points for the management, and the Juran had given the 10 steps in order to improve the quality. As far as the statistical process controls are concerned, rejects the statistically acceptable level of the quality. The Crossbeck will reject it. The Deming, that will give the statistical methods of the quality control that must be used, and the Juran will say that they will recommend the statistical process control, but warns that it can be lead to the tool-driven approach. As far as the improvement basis is concerned, in case of Crossbeck philosophy, a process, it is not a program, and it is the